You can run a best practice assessment once you've Arc enabled your SQL Server with Azure Arc. Dale, do you want to show us how that looks like?
Yeah, I definitely do. Let me share my screen. And so we're looking at one of my Arc enabled SQL Server instances, best practice assessments. And so what that really means is once I onboarded my on-premises SQL Server to Azure through Azure Arc, what Azure Arc did is it ran this assessment of my on-premises SQL Server workload, and it's giving me all kinds of suggestions and recommendations and data about how that on-premises SQL Server is how it stacks up from a best practices assessment. So you see right away, it checks almost 400 or over 400 different controls. You can see I'm or close to 400 different controls. You see I'm passing some of them, basically different categories of status of each of them. You see kind of how they're categorized in terms of administration versus application versus system. If I scroll down a little bit, you'll get a better idea what some of these controls are. Like you can see here, like it's recommending that I enable instant file initialization or that I use strong passwords for the SA account, things like this. All these are recommended to me automatically as part of onboarding the server to SQL. There's no extra cost for this. It's just part of the Arc enabled service. And it gives me a good idea for my on-prem service, how my SQL Server is really performing from a best practice and a security standpoint.
So you can run a whole assessment without the need to migrate those SQL Server to Azure yet?
Yeah, that's absolutely right. That's one of the big values here is you get the server onboarded to Arc. Of course, it stays on-premises along with all its data, but you're getting the power of the cloud to do this best practice assessment right on the on-premises data source.
Beautiful. So leave some comments below for Dale and make sure to check our whole podcast to learn more tips like how to add Defender for Cloud to Azure Arc.